Can I start?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
The few terminologies we should understand about a server and other things also. We'll see those things first. So instead, before we go to what is a 2016 server and all, so we'll go to the normal terminologies also. First one is like peer to peer, not P2P, peer to peer. What is this peer-to-peer or a work group? See here. Look at here. So this is a PC. And this is another PC. Two PCs are there, for example. Okay, so each PC individually acted. So there is no central PC, no central control, nothing is there. So for example, we learn how to connect a printer, right? So this is a printer and it is connected to here. Okay, so printer is connected to this PC and both are connected to a network. Both PCs are connected to your network. Okay, now here there is no server, no client kind of stuff, but in a particular instant, particular time, one act like a server, another act like a client. So for example, printer is connected here. Okay, this is a PC, like a C1, and this is C2. Okay, so C2 want to take a printout. It will send a request to C1, and C1 will through C1 we are taking a printout, right? So in this particular instant, C1 act like a server and C2 act like a client only, but not permanent server and not permanent client kind of stuff. For example, C2 has some data. In the folder, data is there, it is shared. C1 want to access this data. C1 send a request to C2 and access the data through network. So this is like that time, this is act like a server, this is act like a client. So what is the server? Server which provide a particular service or a particular information or particular so we can say particular service or a particular information. Okay, like that. Client will access, client always access information or a data like that from the server, right? So that is a server and client. So here it is, there's no permanent server, no permanent client. It is in the but in that instant only it act like a server and client. Next one is work group. What is this work group? If you are in a work group, you are an individual PC. You have your own administrator. You have your own administrator. This administrator is belongs to, okay, the administrator of this PC. For example, this is a C1 and this is a C2. C1 administrator administrate this PC. For example, not only a name as a administrator, also we can say something like a student one. We'll take a name from here. C1 for example is an account. So yes, Saikiran is an administrator. Okay, he's an administrator of C1. Is an administrator of C1 only. Okay, and he can able to change the settings, he can able to control the system, he can able to create a local group policies like that. So that is completely, so depends upon the function, depends upon the Saikiran only. For example, I take a C2, it is also our group PC, and I need one name is there. for example, JS is an administrator of C2 and control the C2 PC partitioning or maybe installation of application or changing of settings. Everything will be done by this system, Jayashree. As an administrator, she can able to do it. And here, for example, this account want to log into C1 account and want to change or control the C2 PC. He cannot do it. Same as for this administrator cannot be administrate C1 PC. C1 administrator cannot administrate C2. C2 administrator cannot administrate C1. There is no centralized control. Every PC is has a individual administrator only. Okay, no centralized control. Okay, every PC administrate individually. So this is called a decentralized administration. Okay, so this PC not depends upon any PCs. No other accounts log in here. These users cannot log into other PCs. So that is in a work group. Next one is server client. So before we go to the domain, again I will go explain the work group and domain. Okay, so next point is server and client. So here is a server. What is meaning of server? Server provide a service to the client. So what are the services or different services are there? Server means server provide service to client. Okay, and depends upon client request. So what client has to request the server and need this one, then only server will give you, not forcibly giving. So client want to ask server, I want these services. So what kind of services provided by server? Different services are there. Just we'll list out some of the services, common services, for understand. One is like a web server, web services actually, but in a server mode I will tell, like a web server. So web server provide web services. So here it is service and services. Web server provide web services like web pages, right? Next, file server. File server like a FTP server, for example. What is a FTP? File transfer protocol. So if you want to access the files from the server, like you can use a file server like FTP protocol. Of course, different protocols are there, but web server. VPN server provide VPN services if you are working from the work from home kind of stuff. Okay, virtual, private network. What is a virtual private network? If you are working in your office, you directly connected to your database servers, your web servers or email servers or whatever it is, you are directly connecting. Okay, but you are working outside of your organization, you have to use public communication, public IP address, you can use it. Okay, like we are accessing google.com, facebook.com using public IP addresses. Now my infrastructure is in my corporate office, I'm accessing from my home or maybe my branch office. I don't have any leased lines. Guys, you know, I think leased lines means direct connection from your office to your corporate office. Okay, for example, New Jersey is my corporate office. Hyderabad is in my headquarters, main office. Pune is a branch office. So through ISP provider, internet service provider, through that one we can able to establish a connection. Does not mean we are connecting a wire from Hyderabad to New Jersey. We are not putting one single wire. Through ISP provider only, we are take a leased line, means a continuous flow. So no other traffic involved in that one. So we take one complete traffic, one part. Okay, like 1 Mbps, 2 Mbps, 10 Mbps, we'll take it. That is a leased lines. But from home to office, we can't take a leased lines, right? So that is very cost effective. Small branch offices like Pune is there. Pune want to communicate New Jersey head office or maybe Hyderabad office. It is very difficult to spend money on a leased line. So what we will go? We'll go with a VPN. People nowadays work from home people. So they install a VPN. Through VPN, they will establish a connection. So you will get I'm telling a lot of things here. Okay, no problem. Understand, because VPN is one of the important thing. Generally, we use a VPN for work from home and as well as in interview part also. Okay, virtual private network. So when you are connecting, like when you use work from home type, or small branch offices, small offices kind of stuff also, we should consider this work from home. So when you do from your through internet, through internet means through public network, not a private network, through internet you can connect your corporate office, your main office. You can connect your infrastructure, you can connect your corporate office. Office, so better. So otherwise it will become big. Okay, corporate office or your infrastructure, your database server is in your office. Okay, through you can connect it and you can work from it. Okay, for example, I have a SQL developer application is there in my PC. So some application is there to connect SQL database server. Database server is in my corporate office. So I will explain easily. If you know that one, it is quite easy. This is my corporate office. Understand, this is my corporate office. I have a database server. I think you done with the database server, right? This is my database server, and I have a database here. I have a database now. I'm working from home or a branch office, it is there, or a small branch office. Okay, so we don't have a leased lines to establish the connection here. So what I will do? So corporate office maintain VPN server. Corporate office maintaining a VPN server through internet. So this is a internet. So sorry. Internet is always represented in a cloud manner. Okay, or a round symbol, anything. Okay, so first of all, I am connected to internet. I have internet. Now I will put a message like I will tell VPN server details, username and password. So what I have to give? So VPN server, this is a VPN server. So here in my client application, so I have to put VPN server name or a domain name or IP address, username and password. Okay, so when you give like this, and also you have to mention which tunneling protocol you are using, which tunneling protocol you are using, which tunneling protocol you are using. Okay, So whenever you establish send a request, so when you send a request through internet to VPN server, VPN server verify VPN server name, username, password, tunneling protocol, other authentication protocol, authorization protocols. So they'll verify those details here, and everything is okay, then it establish a connection to your system through internet only, everything through internet only, establish a connection. But the communication between your PC and VPN server, okay, or once it is established a connection, what happen actually, it connect your internal corporate network. Inside a corporate network, what are there? So it will connect those things like here. Okay, so it will establish a connection. Your internal corporate network to your laptop or a desktop, okay, a connection will be established through internet only, this is the connection is there, no? The connection is secured because we are using some tunneling protocol. Think like this: you have a public road. In the public road, I created a one private channel, virtually one private channel is there, private route is there. If my car or my bike is came to that route, okay, allowed, so I can go through that one. No one knows I am traveling like that. Okay, I'm traveling. What are the data I'm sending? What car I'm using? What I'm wearing? No one knows. But I'm traveling in public only. Think like that. You're traveling in public, but no one knows what packet you are there. What data in that packet? No one knows. So it is very difficult to tamper the data. What data is transmitting? No one knows. Because we are connected through VPN. So virtual private network connecting one network to another network through internet only, public internet only, using public internet means, internet means public, or a public network, or a internet. You can use name called a internet or a public network. So through public network, you can communicate to your corporate office using VPN server. Okay, so like that, a lot of different things are, including pictures also there. You can type what is VPN server. It is also very good. Okay, virtual private network. So you can read. Encapsulate and transmit network data, typically internet protocol data, over other networks, such as system enable access resources, something is given. Okay, yeah, you can read what is VPN kind of stuff. Establish secure connection between you and internet via VPN. All data traffic is routed through a encrypted virtual channels. Different virtual channels are there, PPTP, S2TP, like that, L2TP, layer to tunneling protocol, point to point tunneling protocol, secure socket tunneling protocol, so IKE. So these are different type of tunneling protocols are there, so it will secure it. So one of the server is VPN server. Read about VPN server, virtual private network. WDS server. What is WDS server? Windows Deployment Server. Okay, it means it will install operating system through remotely. Okay, through network we can install operating system. Through network, so we can install operating system. Windows operating system, of course. So WDS services, WSUS server. Okay, it is a update server. Okay, so you update, we are updating our PCs individually because we are in a home network. But in a organization, enterprises, lot of PCs are there, no? 100, 200 PCs are there. Every PC should be updated through internet. It is more burden on internet. So what this update server, it will download the updates, required updates, and update the PCs in the network. So what based on the required updates only we'll do it. Normally, every update we are getting, instead of that one, so we can specifically certain updates we are download and install to clients. So that is a Windows update server. Active Directory or authentication server. In Windows, we use Active Directory domain services. Okay, Active Directory domain services. Okay, authentication server, Kerberos server, authentication server, DHCP server. What is DHCP server? Provide IP address, provide or a configure IP addresses to clients. Okay. DNS server name to IP address mapping. It means whenever you given a name, for example, you type in a browser google.com or facebook.com, but actually in the network we communicate with the IP addresses only, not with the name. But when you type a google.com, the request is going to DNS server, and DNS server will give you IP address. Understand? DNS server will give you IP address. If you want to see, go to CMD. Just I'm trying to ping www.google.com. It is not communicating google.com with the name. First it is got IP address and try to communicate to google.com. So see that IP address here. This is a google.com IP address for now. Okay. Ping to facebook.com. So then the actual name is something, but IP address you are getting. So this is a DNS. What DNS will do? When you are communicating with the name of a domain or a URL or anything, you will get IP address and you communicate with the IP address only. That is a DNS server. Okay. Like that, lot of servers are there. VPN server, WDS server, WDS server. DHCP server, authentication servers like Active Directory servers, domain controllers, Active Directory, ADDS means domain controller. LDAP servers. Okay. Storage servers, file servers, storage servers also there, iSCSI servers also there, network policy servers are there, like a certification service, federation services, VPN server, Hyper-V servers, like that, different servers are there. Okay, what is these servers? Servers provide a service to the client. Web server provider, web services, file server service, FTP services, VPN server make a connection through internet, so it establish the connection from your corporate office to your home connection. WDS server provide operating system installations, update server, authentication server, user login verification, DHCP IP services, DNS name to IP addresses, like that. iSCSI server, storage servers, like that, so many servers are there. So all over the server means it provides a service, and this is a machine, and we install a operating system in that machine. Okay, so which operating system? Server operating system we are installing, and we install a service, then that become a server. Guys, again I will tell. So a machine become a server. So first step is OS. Okay, so based on operating system, if you install server OSs, then it is become that server. For example, you install 2016 server OS, it become 2016 server, but it is nothing. If you install a service, for example, install a DHCP service, okay, then it is become DHCP server. Install DHCP server service, DHCP server. If you install DNS service, DNS server. If you install Active Directory, so it Active Directory domain services, it become domain controller. If you install a WDS, it become a WDS server. If you install a WSUS, it become an update server. Okay, so routing and remote access services, it become a VPN server, like that. So depends upon what service you are installed, that server is act like a, that server provide a, if that service like a DHCP service, DNS service, like that. The client will access the services. How many multiple clients can able to access the services? Not only one client here, not in a one instant. Always server act like a server only, in a particular server, as a particular server only. Server provide a services to client. And for example, this is a DHCP server, provide a services to IP address to the client machines. Understand, server is a server, client is a client, client access the services, server provide a services. Depends upon what services you installed. So based on that, it provide a services. And the name of the server is also main based on the service it is providing. Name of the server based on the service it is providing. Okay, so that is the server and client. What makes a server as a server? Also, we can discuss that one. So where it is here? Important in one is what make a server as server. What makes server as a particular server? It means what service it is providing. Depends upon what service. DHCP service, DNS service, authentication service, VPN service, like that. Okay, print service, print servers, print services, like that. Main important is service. Next, sometimes we call a server as a server, not in the terms of services. So that is depends upon what server OS you installed. Like a Windows Server 2012, 2016, Linux, Unix, these are all makes a server as a server. So it depends upon what server OS you installed. Okay, based on that, we call that server as a server. First one is important. First one is the actual one. Remaining also we are terminologies. Okay, we'll do it. Next. Based on hardware. We have a desktop. We call our machine as a desktop, laptop, like that only, right? Because of our desktop is installed with a desktop based operating system only, right? But for to install server operating system and services, we need a proper hardware also. Proper hardware also. Not desktops are not suitable. Desktop, regular desktop hardwares not suitable for a server in the enterprise. Okay, in a real time we should not use our desktop machines for a server purpose, because the server hardware is a little bit different from regular desktop usage. Okay, so what makes a server as a server important is based on services. Based on services, services what it is providing. Another way of server, like a 2016 server. You didn't know services are there, but still we can call it as a 2016 server. Next, hardware base, tower server, blade server, and other services also there. So we'll see that one. Next, one more is important is because of we talk about application. What? Am I recording, right? Yeah, recording is there. This is external window. Yeah, ask me, no problem. We can make a server with the installation of application. So here in application, we have a server application and client side application also there. Okay. So server, if you install an application that is like a server kind of application, so then that server become a Putler server. For example, you install a Tomcat. Tomcat is an application. You install a Tomcat and it is server become a application server or a web server also. If you install a WebLogic, then your server become a application server. If you install a SQL database, if you install a SQL database server, right? Database server. If you install a Oracle SQL, for example, SQL database application. So if you install Oracle SQL database application, you install it, then that become a database server, right? Based on application only. You can install, you take a Windows 7 or Windows 10, you install a Oracle database in that one and you are accessing through a network. So that is a server now. You don't require server operating system also. Through application, you can able to do it. Okay. Mail servers like Microsoft Exchange server. Okay. Microsoft Exchange server is a mail server. Different mail servers also there. Okay. For example, Zimbra. Okay. Zimbra is also a application. Exchange server is also an application. MS SQL server. Okay. Mail servers is based on applications. You know, IBM. Domino, and Lotus Note is a client, mail server a client. Now it is belongs to HCL, of course. Now it is belongs to HCL. This is a mail server by application. This is a mail client by application only. Pure form. Mail servers, Exchange servers, Zimbra, client, Outlook, or a web browser, database servers based on application also become a server. So what makes a server as a server? By providing a Putler services. So mail server, mail services, DHCP server, DNS server, like that. Based on operating system you install, Windows operating system, Linux operating system. So when you are come to the server part, so different operating systems are there, right? Server OSs, so Windows servers. Windows servers from starting with NT 2000, 2003, 2008, let's go on 2012. So I am removing one or two parts, okay? So 2019. Okay, I didn't put R2, 32-bit, 64-bit like that, just Windows servers. Of course, Linux servers, Linux-based servers also there, Red Hat Enterprise Linux, Red Hat Enterprise Linux, CentOS, Oracle OS, Unix-based servers, IBM, mainframe servers, different type of servers are there. Color is HP UX, IBM AS400, okay, AS400. So these are all mainframe servers. So different servers are there. Okay. Application based servers, already I given application based servers. So this is again, you can copy and put it here. This is our application based servers. So if you install a application, then it become a server. If you install operating system, it is services. In operating system, different services are there. You have to install the services. Okay. Next, hardware based servers. Okay. So different type of hardwares you use it. Normally we use a single CPU, normal motherboards like a. So if you take a desktop PCs like. Single sockets are there, CPU socket, single CPU socket, okay. Limited number of cores, limited number of CPU cores. CPU cores are there, like a 4-core processor, 8-core processor, like that only it is there, not generally high level. Okay. So next one is RAM. Max capacity is limited. Okay. So RAM max capacity is limited. RAM sockets are limited. In a normal desktop, okay, motherboard size is different, power supply, disk management, SCSI mounting, RAID controllers are not there in a normal desktop. So normal don't have a desktop, don't have direct any SCSI controllers or RAID controllers. No chance like this kind of stuff. So what is this server motherboards? By server motherboards, server things, so possible multiple CPU sockets are there. Okay, the CPU also multi-core processors. Example, Xeon processor, verify Xeon processor. Okay, so RAM slots are good. So okay, higher RAM capacity. We put a more RAM capacities here. Okay, so there is a chance of SCSI controller, RAID controller on board. Or through PCS slot, okay. Or through PCS slot, SCSI controller possible, and RAID controllers also there. Okay, so like this, server motherboards has a more higher capacity than a normal desktop or one. Okay, So desktop more given for a graphical part, but servers more concentrate on performance part. Okay, so desktop aim is user experience. Okay, so desktop main aim is user experience, application running of applications, playing games. Games, multimedia, games, multimedia. What is multimedia? Like video. Yeah, music, pictures, like that. Or creating, editing, or playing of a thing. So like that, this is a application running, processing, and some application working on the desktop, internet browsing. Okay, this is the main aim of desktop. So that is because of that one, a limited is there. But server hardware main aim is providing services. Provide services to multiple. Provide services to multiple user base, multiple computers, multiple users. Right? So multiple users, there are accessing the services, providing the services. Required more storage capacity, not for playing games and all. So more storage capacity is required, more processing capacity is required. Data processing is more processing, storage requirement is there. So based on that, different servers are there. One is tower server, rack server. Next one is blade server. Okay, so in a hardware servers, tower server, rack server, and blade server is there. The tower server means if you see any desktop, so that is usually like tower server type only, means towers, that we call it as a tower. What is this tower servers? You can go to images, you can see here it is. See, this is a tower server. It is look like normal desktop, right? So you can open it if you want. So just I've opened this one. You can see here a tower server. You can see the configuration, Xeon processor. Okay, second generation, 6-core processor, 16 GB RAM, open bay. This basic server itself 1,25,900. If you want to add extra processor or extra RAM or all kind of stuff, it keep increases. If you want a operating system, see, operating system cost standard edition 61,500. Data center edition, this is also standard edition only. This is OEM DVD, both are same. Oh, 2016 61,000, 2019 75,000. Both are standard edition STD. Okay, like this is the given details about it. How many RAMs are there? Like maximum RAM capacity. Can you able to see here? It is how many slots? 12 slots are there. Okay. Dual process support means two processor you can able to put it. Socket, two sockets are there on motherboard. This is a maximum capacity, 768 GB. 12 slots are there. like that 16 GB, 16 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB, like that we can put it. Open bay, hot swappable, possible maximum 8 hard disk we can there. Write support is there. Can you see write support 015? Power supply 750 watts. Two 1 Gbps Ethernet ports are there. Two are there. Keyboard, mouse, monitor not giving. Operating system not included. 3 years warranty. Okay. See, this is the server capacity. Just for the example, I'm showing. This is a tower server. So see the capacity of the server. Next. Tower servers are at towers only. So like it's look like a desktop, but mid towers, high towers are there. Okay. Next. Rack server or rack mount servers. Rack servers or rack mount servers. This is a kind of rack servers only. Rack server or rack mount servers. Can you see? It is a rack. It's a rack. You can open the rack. Okay, this is a rack only. Okay, this is a rack only. So this is a internal part of rack, like a your system only. If you open the system, it is look like a tower normally, but if you tilt it like a, if you put it in a horizontal way, normally tower is vertical, rack is horizontal, but same thing, we can insert a RAMs, processor, hard disk, SSDs, everything is same only. You can see it is a 2U rack server, Xeon processor silver, and 8 core processor, 16 GB RAM, and open bay 194,700 onwards. It means anything you want, you can add it here. Extra processor, so single processor is itself 64,900, this model. Okay, 16 GB RAM, this is the capacity now it is. 32 GB RAM, like this. And also see the specifications here. Okay, SAS hard disk are there, 8 like SCSI hard disk are there. You can see he is inserting this side, this picture. He is inserting a blade. Here he is inserting a rack. Rack is like this. Okay, this is a rack server. For example, if I want more servers, tower server is a single server, but I need a more servers. I need at least 4 servers for my infrastructure. So what I will do, I'll choose like a rack servers. So in the single rack, you can see full complete this rack space. You can put a multiple racks inside. Okay, like this, or you can put a rack like this, multiple racks you can put it, so a lot of wiring and all kind of stuff will be reduced. So you can find the difference between rack and other things. Next one is a blade server. Next one is a blade server. So when I say it is server, just a server, it does not contain anything. Okay, so this is a blade server. We'll type directly blade server. Okay. This is a like a blade servers. You can see whatever the tower server or a blade server or rack server, same thing only. Processor, RAM, motherboard, power connections, and storage like a SSD or a. Usually SSDs are there in blade, okay, hard disk or network connections. So these are in a server, right? Same thing in this blade only. Just these blades, if you see in a single rack, multiple blades we can able to insert it. The rack size is bigger, so multiple blades we can put it. Means tower server is a single server. If you have a 4 tower servers, means it will occupy a space, lot of wiring, complex network. If you are going with a more servers, okay. if you go to more servers, better to go to blade servers. Okay, so sorry, rack servers. So in a one single big rack, you can put a multiple servers, like a 4 or 5 servers, you can able to put it. If it is not enough, you are going with the more servers and more storage spaces and easy to change kind of stuff, okay, without having any much screws and all. Hot swappable servers also there. Means you can remove the server and re-enter server like this. You can see is removing the server and resetting the server. So like this, the each rack contains a multiple servers, okay, and storage spaces in the rack and also available. So this is a blade servers. It reduces the size and more servers possible. We can able to fit into single space like that. So these are all things. So whatever the person, this person is working, this entire setup, we call it as a data center. This entire setup, we call it as a single data center. Like that, multiple blade servers, storage spaces, and those racks combinedly, we call it as a complete data center. This is full data center. Okay, you can type in a Google data center, blade server, data center servers. Okay, so different architectures are there. See, this is a entirely how many, each one having a multiple blades, but if you see like this, this is a entirely blade servers. Okay, and this is a complete data centers. Full multiple data centers are there. See, to get inside, it is not much easy. You should have a authorization required, compulsory. They will check entire, you know, airport security is also, we can't compare with here. So you should not carry any metallic things inside, including pen drive, CD ROMs, magnetic tapes, or pins, buttons. Also, you should not wear any mechanical or electrical things, mechanical things, material like metals. You should not carry inside. Lot of radiation, electromagnetic radiation is very high inside. Okay, and complete sealed room. It is a complete sealed room. Okay, the temperature balance, everything will be there. Okay, so very dangerous electromagnetic waves generated from the data centers. And person should be authorized thoroughly. They verify the user who is going inside. And out of total big data center, only 10-20 members only work. Okay, if something is happened, then we'll go thick, agile, thick system. Okay, we'll see who will get a data center maintenance job. That is also in a profile. Okay, so this is about your hardware servers. So hardware server means the server hardware is higher than a normal desktop server, and different type of server types are there based on the hardware sizes, space occupation, connections, tower server, rack server, and blade servers. So this is all about your the server. Again, a small repeating. Server and client. Server provide a service, client access the service. Client access service from server. Okay, different type of services are providing by server, like a web server, VPN server, DHCP server, DNS server, mail server, database servers, update servers, authentication servers. So different type of servers are there, services and servers are there. So what makes a server as a server mainly depends upon what type of service the server is providing. That only main consideration depends upon what service server is providing. Okay, that is the main considerations. Next, type of OS you installed in the server. Type of OS you install in the server, like a Windows Server Operating System, Linux Server Operating System, Unix Server Operating System, or any other server operating systems you installed, that makes as that server on. But if you don't install services in that one, if you are not providing any services, it is a just a server only. That's it. It is not any use of services. So compulsory, a server means it should provide a services. Next, hardware type of servers are there. It means if you purchase a server related hardware, server based processors, RAM capacities and all, it means it's a server hardware, server kind of stuff. Okay, different type of hardware servers are there. Tower server, like a look like a desktop server. Our desktops are mid towers, but in a servers they use high towers, means bigger the motherboards, multiple sockets, multiple RAM sockets are available, CPU sockets are available, onboard SCSI and RAIDcontrollers are available. Okay, so for a tower server, the tower server, if you need a more tower server, so instead of by purchasing 4 or 5 tower servers, better to go with the rack servers, because rack servers will occupy a lesser space than a tower servers, and maintenance is quite easy, lesser the complex than a tower server connections, power connections, motherboard, keyboard, monitor, keyboard, mouse, network connections are little bit complex if you are using number of tower servers. Okay, so rack servers are keep it in one side only, and we can easily connect and maintain easily. Blade servers are also like a rack servers only, but rack server occupy one single rack, but blade server will take multiple blades. We can able to insert in a one single rack, and like that one single data center you can put a multiple blade server. Myself, I seen one data center, single data center only, means one piece only, so that contains 8 blades. So 4+4 blades are there, which is given access to student, and one storage server inside, like a storage space is also there, router, switches, so the combination. So if you see a data center, okay, so data center means it contains, of course, blade servers or rack servers, switches, router or routers, switches, router, patch cables, patch cable, your networking cables, fiber channels, so fiber channels, SAN or NAS type of storages, centralized storages. So for that's why we are using fiber channels, okay, patch cables, blade servers, cooling system separately. Power supply, SMTP, like power supplies, there, na? SMTP power supplies separately. Okay, this is a these are all available in your data centers. So racks, modules, closures, enclosures, ventilations are a common things. So this is a hardware based servers. Next, application based servers. Applications based server means if you install an application in your machine, so automatically your machine become that server. Okay, so whatever the operating system you are using, sometimes you are installing an application, based on that application it become a server, like a Oracle database. If you install it, is become database server, SQL servers, Microsoft SQL server, Exchange server, Zimbra, IO, Domino, like, so you can see different type of applications are there. So whenever you install a server application, the the machine becomes server. Here we have to combine everything. It means if you want a server, it means you have to choose your server hardware. On server hardware, you have to install server operating system, okay, and install a services as per your server operating system. Again, what it is, if you want a server, generally, okay, so choose your hardware. What hardware you choose the server first? You want to best in an organization, you want to build a server. Okay, so choose your hardware, tower server, blade server, what type of CPU, what type of RAM, how much RAM, disk. So choose your hardware, server related hardware mainly. Okay, choose your hardware and choose your server operating system. Choose your operating system. Okay, server operating system, desktop operating system, whatever it is. So in general, server operating system. Here, install what service you require. Install a service, make that one as a server. Install related service like DHCP, DNS, like that. Install a services, then server become that services. Otherwise, install a application to make that one as a server. Yes. So these are all not separate. It is a layer by layer. Select a hardware, select operating system, install a service or install an application. So then your server become a particular server. Yeah. Ask me. Tell me the question. What happened? No one is asking. Okay. If in case like your mic or something is not connected, you can put it in the chat box. Definitely I will give answer. Okay. Guys, understand this one or not at all understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So very good. Understand means you are not listen. You don't understand means not in listen. Okay, so whatever it is, go through what is server, different type of services or a different type of servers. Okay, this is layers, like understanding of servers. Work group and domain, I will go through that one again part. Okay, so here what is peer to peer, server and client, what is work group, what is domain. These are basic questions are there. So what is a work group? Work group is a individual PC, decentralized administration. What is a work group? Work group is a decentralized administration. Decentralized administration. Okay, so every PC, so PC has has own administrator. They have then their own administrator. So local administrator. Control the PC. Okay, so in a work group, so local administrator, the administrator control the PC. No centralized administrator. No centralized admin. No centralized control. No centralized admin as well as no centralized control. No centralized admin and no centralized control. Okay. In a work group, if you are in a work group, you want a particular service, then you have to search for the service and access. Okay, you have to search for access particular. Okay, I will explain again for group and domain. Just here I'm giving some differences. Domain is a centralized administration. These are a, look like a small things, but it is sometimes they ask. Okay, so the domain domain administrator control all PCs. PCs in network. All PCs in domain, actually. All PCs in the domain. Okay, not network, actually. All PCs in the domain. Network is different. Okay, so a domain administrator is an administrator for all. Domain admin is the admin for all. The all multi types. Okay, so admin for all. Okay, centralized administration. Okay, centralized control. Domain admin is a admin for everyone. Okay, so here any user we can enforce settings to all PCs in domain. Okay, here we have to change settings by local admin only, but here you can enforce settings to PCs in the domain using group policies. And any user in domain can log in to any PC in domain. Any user means any domain user can log in to any PC in domain. PC in domain, meaning is PC in domain. Okay, here in our group, okay, user of a PC cannot log in to other PCs. I will explain again in a practically again, both we can see it. Okay, my throat is keep drying. So that's it.